Hey there, Power Platform enthusiasts. Stefan Superfloof here. Welcome back to our channel. Today we're going to explore a real-world use case straight from the wild, hot off the presses this last week. Here's the use case. They want to add a Power App front end to their SharePoint database. Pretty straightforward so far, right? Here's the tricksy part. They're using a SharePoint lookup column. They want to use a custom sort order from that reference list. And they only want to show certain items in another choice field if a lookup column item is selected. This is going to be fun, right? But before we get started, do us a favor, smash that like button, hit subscribe, and ring that bell. You don't want to miss any of our Power Platform adventures and tutorials. Trust me, you'll thank yourself later for staying in the loop with the latest tips, tricks, and everything else that we've got up our sleeve, or should I say toe beans. Let's start with the finished product first. Here we are in my dev tenant in my Sky Ranch Aviation site. All of this is dummy data. I'll never show client data in the real world. I will step through how we set up this app from start to finish, as well as the custom filtering. But let's look at the use case first. For a new record or an edit record, the client type determines what is shown in services requested. If I have client type empty, the first three here are full type rating course, shortened, and recurrent. First off, obviously not alphabetical. There's a custom order here that the client wanted. Notice shortened type rating. For this use case, we wanted this option hidden if student pilot is selected. I select student pilot. Now the option is gone. Let's look at the data source first. Here we have the custom list within SharePoint showing all of the records. If we go into list settings and scroll down to that column, we have service requested other. It's a lookup. This is a special type of column within SharePoint that allows you to pull in data from a separate source. When you're leveraging just SharePoint, this is great because then you only have one source of truth. Let's say the services requested change on a monthly basis. You don't have to go into multiple places to update. You only update once and all of your other locations automatically get updated. PowerApps doesn't play very nice with lookup columns, so we're going to have to do a bit of a logic loop workaround. This list also has a separate column called order. This is the order that the client wanted the items shown in, full type, shortened, recurrent, just like we saw in the Power App, filtered here by student pilot. So let's get into the meat and potatoes of the code. If I come in here to the dropdown, here's what we're doing, and I'll get into how we do all this in a minute, but I wanted to give you a chance to look at it first. I will put all of this in the comments as well, so you can peruse it at your own leisure. Go ahead and pause if you like. Okay, so what we have here is because SharePoint doesn't work well with the lookup columns, I am pulling in both lists. Not a problem for me because it works the same way as a lookup column within SharePoint. Let's build this from the ground up. Here we are at make.powerapps.com. Normally I would do a custom design, but since this use case is only to illustrate the custom filtering and sorting, I'm just going to leverage SharePoint's out of the box template. And how we do that is by starting with data or with page design, but today we're going to start with data. And from here, I can upload an Excel file. I can start with blank, select an existing table or external data. And PowerApps considers SharePoint and Excel and other things external data. So we're going to select that one. Now we wait for the list to populate. It'll pull in my user profile and it'll pull in the SharePoint sites that I've accessed recently. So we're going to select Sky Ranch and then I could search by request, and there we have it, requested services requested, create the app. Now this is going to go through and create the galleries, the search, everything that we need for this use case. This might work for one of your use cases as well. However, this is also a great way to learn from. And this app is responsive out of the box. So if you're wondering how to do responsive apps, this is a good place to start. If I were to play the app, take it to a smartphone, and then I'm going to rotate it. You'll notice how this left gallery view disappears. Great way to learn by looking at someone else's code. So, pretty close to what we want. Obviously, there's a couple little differences in the gallery. So here within the gallery, I'm going to select this item here. It's giving us the ID, not really what we want. What we want are client type here. So as I start typing, Intellisense starts helping me out. I'm going to, on my keyboard, up and down arrow to client type, then hit tab. And you see how we have a red squiggly line that's indicating an error. I'm going to hit period, and Intellisense gives me the next option. I hit tab and we're done. Now, if we look at the form, client type determines what service request it is shown. So we're going to move this up here. The GUI interface allows us to click and drag. You saw how I clicked on a card, click on the black bar, and I'm able to move things around. Now, notice in the black bar that it's locked. If we want to make a change to this, we have to first unlock it. So if we go to advanced, we can click unlock to change properties. Now, why did I do that? This form is in, if I select the form, it shows us that it is in a view mode. Up here, if I hold down the Alt key on my keyboard and hit the pencil, now the form is in an edit mode. We're able to come in here and make changes to existing forms. I'm going to cancel that. I could delete it too because I accidentally clicked twice. I'm going to hit cancel there. I'm going to create a new record. And why I unlocked this card is for this reason. Out of the box, drop downs and combo boxes have default text in there. This works for 90% of the items. I'm going to click on advanced and scroll down. And from here, I can make my change. I'm going to click, highlight the text, and change it to select one. Let's do the same thing for service requested. I select the card, I unlock it. This time, I'm going to change the text in this dropdown a different way. Microsoft knows that not everyone does things the same way, so they give us multiple options. I can scroll down and type in here on the right. However, I'm going to click on the text of input text placeholder, and I'm going to change it from right here. So I'm going to move over and type in select one. Now, I'm going to select that dropdown one more time because I selected out of it, and I'm going to click the dropdown next to it. Notice that the items here, input text placeholder is bold. That's because I made a change to it. That's a really easy way to see where things might have been changed from default. If I come down here to items, this is giving us the out of the box what this card is doing. If I were to make a change here, let's say I go to the home or the start, and I comment out this line. Now I come back here and items is bold. Just some of the little tricks and tips that I've picked up along the way. I'm going to move my mouse up here and I can select this dropdown to give myself more working space. I can also click and drag to give myself even more working space. Now, why did I comment out the choices? When I'm working within a SharePoint form, I like to save that for future use. You never know when you might need to reference it again, so having it is pretty handy. Here we have the code in the finished app. Let's review it from the top down. So if I select within the code, you'll see how we have a green background here. If data card value 6.selected.value is something. If I make this a little bit smaller, you'll see that IntelliSense has also highlighted the field. So we know that that data card that I'm referencing is this one here. Make this bigger so we can see it. So if the data card value selected is not student pilot, then we're going to show everything in the order of the secondary list. If it is student pilot, then we're filtering out the value based on the order ID from the list. So if we look here, sort order 2 is shortened type rating, and that's what's hidden on the final app. So let's implement this code into our working app. Move this off to the side. Now I've gone ahead and I added in the second list. If you need to be refreshed on how to do that, you can look at one of my previous videos. I'll put the link in here for you. If we expand out our code base, we have more room to work. This is the other reason why it's handy to keep this. We're going to have to leverage this a few times. So let's start typing. So if, and I put a paren in, data card value 6 dot, and I always like to check myself here because you will spend hours troubleshooting the wrong dropdown if you don't. Just trust but verify. Now the dot selected. Now, because this is only one item, you can't select multiple things, we're just going to do selected dot value. If it doesn't equal, and this is another trick that I've learned through the hard knocks, I'm going to minimize this. I'm going to click here and edit the data. I'm actually going to come out to the list and grab that text. And this is the wrong list, so I go back to my app and I can select here, edit data. We want to get the list or the text from the drop-down column that is causing all of the actions to happen. So I go into list settings and I go into client type. I like to copy and paste. You'll spend hours troubleshooting a mistyping. So copy the text from here, go back into our code. So if the value doesn't equal student pilot, then we're going to do something. Else we're not. So I'm going to just close that out. This is where that commented code will come in handy. For right now, we're going to put it in here as both conditions, and then I'm going to hit format text. So what we have is, no matter what we select, we're going to have the same results, but we want to handle these two very differently. So I'm going to give us a little bit of space here. The first thing that we need to do is evaluate if it doesn't equal student pilot. All we want to do here is sort by the order that is in our list. So if we go back and look at our list, we have a column here called order. It looks like it's called order. Let's go into the list settings, always trust but verify, because you may have it called something else on the back end. Especially if you bring something in from Excel, this can be wonky, and this is just a good habit pattern to get into. Once I hover over the name of the column, you can see in the bottom there, the field is actually order 0. If I click on the column name, it'll pop up in the URL bar as well, order 0. This will help you make sure that you're referencing the right location. So back to our code. What we want to do here for this option is just sort. So we're going to sort the first option by the column that we're going to reference in the service requested list. So how are we going to start this code? We are going to start by sorting columns, and Intellisense is helping us sort by columns. But what column? We have to add a column first, and you see how IntelliSense is helping us. I put in a paren. It says, okay, what are we adding columns to? If I click away, we're adding columns to our choices from SharePoint, the lookup column, right? So what column are we adding? You can call this whatever you want, but for consistency's sake, because I don't want my coworkers to hate me if they have to work on this app in the future, I'm going to call it order. Now, we have to somehow, let me get that out of the way. We have to somehow add the column, but we have to add the column that matches, right? So the title has to match the value. So what we're going to do here is we're going to not just filter, but we're going to first filter. And why we're doing that is because when you filter a list or, a collection either, you'll get a table of data back. We don't want the table. We know there's only one record in there. So I'm going to just get the first record. So this is going to be from our service requested list, the other list. And what we're going to do from there, oops, not a paren. We're going to sort it by the value equals the title. So the value from our lookup has to match the title column from our list. So this guy right here. So now's where we get into the fun, right? So from here, and IntelliSense isn't going to really help you. What we want, we have two quotes in there. We're going to put order in here, the column name. Then we're going to do another order. And you see IntelliSense is helping us now. It's catching on. It's like, oh, I think I know what you want. And then what column are we going to sort by? We're going to sort by the column order. And what order do you want it to sort by? Sort order ascending. Microsoft likes to change things. We have to close the paren. So Microsoft likes to change things. Sort order dot ascending is what works now, but it didn't work a few months ago. So if you're watching this video in the future and my code isn't exactly same, it may just be something as simple as syntax changing. And I add a comma right here for the if statement. And that gives us what we want. I'm gonna hit format text because it's easier for me to read. Now if I highlight all of this and come down here and select the little drop-down arrow, it's gonna show me that it is now sorting by the order I've defined, by this column I created called order. That's the easy part. Now that we have all this logic down, we can copy and paste it and add in the functionality to filter out if the order number, and this is what we're using here, order two, if this equals that, don't show it, right? So we're gonna filter that out. So we're going to take this exact same statement, and if I click my mouse here, it shows me where the close paren is. I'm gonna grab all this and I'm gonna copy it, and I'm gonna come down here and I'm gonna get rid of this because we don't need it now. But before I type in anything, I'm gonna do a filter statement, and then I'm gonna paste what I had, and what are we filtering by? We're filtering by the order not equals to two. And then we have to do a paren in there to close out the statement. Format the text again. I'll expand this out. If you want to look at it, you can pause here. Again, I'll have it in the comments for you. Okay, I'm going to click the right arrow to bring it back up. And now let's test it. So let's play the app. Let's play it as a window size. I know this is blank. I'm going to show you how to fix that in a minute too. So if we select private pilot, we get all the options here. If we select student pilot, our option is hidden. Now, this is a little gotcha that drove me nuts for a while. If you come down here and turn allow searching back on, it'll get kicked off when it errors out. That'll give you the text back. Another little gotcha. And there we have it. We have our conditional formatting on top of our custom sort order. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Let us know your thoughts, questions, and any topics you'd like us to cover in future videos. Sharing is caring, so don't forget to share this tutorial with your fellow PowerApps enthusiasts. Until next time, keep learning, keep exploring, and keep rocking PowerApps like a true pro. See you in the next video.